Hi, welcome to this week's Desmond Saunders. And as you can see, we're at the Packhurst Bridge car park. Birds singing, and with the river higher than we've seen it previous visits, welcome to the Packhurst Bridge, Glenlivet. The river is flowing high. There's a fair amount of water in it compared with previous visits.
I did say I was going to have a say about one or two things, so here's one. Inverters. Why? Many people say, oh, they need their inverter to run the charger for this, that or the other. 12 volts is fine. You can get chargers for most things, which step up to the 19 volts required for most laptops, etc. It's more efficient to go from 12 to 19 than it is from 12 to 240 back to 19. The way they do it to get to 19 is a 24 volt step down transformer, so you end up with 24 volts. They'll rectify that and then regulate it down to 19 volts. So you're going to be wasting a good deal of that energy as heat. The same with an inverter. It converts the 12 up to 240 and it gets warm. Believe me, that's why they have fans on. And that heat is waste energy. Now, I'm not saying 12 volt to 19 volt is efficient, but step mode, modern step mode chargers, which is what they are, step up the 12 volt to the required voltage with no problem at all. They do get a little bit warm, but believe me, you'll be wasting less energy. Don't need inverters unless you want to run hair dryers and things like that. Then that's a personal choice. But for just charging electronics, you're better with 12 volt to 19 volt type charger. Even 12 volt to 24 volt, doubling the voltage is no problem with a step mode. Thank you. Last year, there was some controversy on social media, just in a small way, to do with car parking at graveyards and the like, and why motorhomes shouldn't use them. Well, my question to you then, if it's not acceptable to park at a graveyard, why is it acceptable to turn the church that was once at the centre of that graveyard into a private house? Now, I have no religious reasons not to do it. I also have no religious reasons not to park outside a graveyard. Over to you on answers to that. My thought is, if it's not being used for the purpose of which it was used, there is no problem with converting a church, a school, or any other building into habitation. Make it into a house. Some churches are huge, they could be used for multiple purposes. Housing homeless, getting people off the streets and into a warm shelter. Old schools, instead of pulling them down and building a housing estate on them, perhaps that could be used for those as well. Parking at graveyards isn't a problem. Okay, if there's a service going on, a burial or some sort of memorial, then yeah, it's probably bad form and you shouldn't. And if there's one going to take part, move on. A large amount of the time, those car parks are empty. What's the harm in an overnight stop? Might be a bit different setting up camp for a week. That's not what we're about. This week's Desmond's Donders. We'll hope you join us next time for more Donders around Scotland with our motorhome Desmond. Goodbye for now.